For centuries, the British roamed the world, slapping English names on just about everything. So when it came time to promote Great Britain in China, we thought the Chinese might like to return the favour with great Chinese names for Great Britain.
Now, Britain is launching its largest ever tourism campaign, and it's based around asking people to choose the Chinese name for a range of British landmarks.
We want funny names, we want thought-provoking names, we want names which are poetic.
就叫它那个迷字小镇，自由之路，荣耀之路，山坡上的蚯蚓。
We invited them to suggest names for over 100 iconic British attractions online, and the names poured in.
女王驾到，霞道林，摘星塔，七燕谷，白色大裸奔，高帅富之路。
For places not listed on the site, namers were encouraged to personally visit the location and be the first to upload their submissions to Weibo, along with proof of visit. A Chinese Beatles fan named Yu Run grabbed the opportunity to name Beatles landmarks in London and Liverpool.
现在终于命名完了，它就叫潘尼路了。The
namers received certificates, and the names were immortalized on Wikipedia, Baidu, and Google Maps, and the campaign became a talking point, both in China and abroad.
The new Chinese name for the Gherkin Building in London translates quite literally to the pickled little cucumber.
The famous Highland Games, some feel it could be better translated as strong man, skirt party.
This was the first time in history one country had invited the citizens of another to come up with names for its major landmarks. And as a result, Britain is greeting a lot more Chinese tourists this year.
Thank you very much. 大功告成了，我可能创造了一段小历史。